We're still recording this now, and the two of us are fixing our hair.
I'm just putting the best bits.
It could be the bloopers.
We're the two of us fixing our hair. Yeah, looking good back to you, Mickey. Yeah, looking good.
Are we back?
Yeah, we're back in action. Nick, when you were doing the part with the tin whistle, where you had to throw the tin whistle, and you know, that section where you come on, and was there anything that ever, when you went on to do that, was there anything ever that would bother you or worry you, or was there anything you were afraid of?
Yeah, Dangerous Games was that piece. So I was Darren Nolan's understudy, or lieutenant, so to speak, and there was a part in the show where obviously Dara would throw the tin whistle to me and I'd have to catch it. But the problem was my step, my 8 bars kind of started like a little bit offbeat. 6, 7, 8. So the catch and the first tap were kind of almost the same.
Same. So, oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I had to kind of concentrate on dancing and catching this small little silver whistle flying in the air
in like the biggest stage,
lights in your face and everything. And I often laughed with the likes of my mate Adrian Buck about what would happen if, imagine if I dropped it and then it rolled under one of the towers and I was like on all four fingers trying to get at it and the music still going, you know.
Did you ever drop it, Mick?
I dropped it one time, yeah, and it fell in two little pieces. But I was lucky that my step had a little gap in it. It went da 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 da. Pause. Pick da 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 da.
Very good.
Save the day.
I can kind of got back in time, but it was a bit of a pressure. But the thing that I was worried about every night was that I dropped this whistle in front of thousands of people, you know.
Well, go with that story, Mick, about Victory March.
Okay, all right. So, does everybody remember the Victory March at the end, where we all had to walk on in different, like, linear kind of formations? Yeah, that piece, right?
And we wore the long clothes and we had candles.
We all had our black cloaks and we all had our candle side stage set out ready. And the candles were about maybe like 12 inches long with a little battery operated
button on it.
And you would press and it would come on. I remember.
And yours didn't come on, is it?
Yeah, well, no, it wasn't that. It was actually, I went to get my candle and my cloak. My cloak was there. Cloak went on. And you hadn't a huge amount of time to get on, but I, long story short, I couldn't find it. It wasn't there, but there was an Irish Independent newspaper that was on a flight case that was backstage, and I rolled it up and I held it with two hands and out I went. And that's the opening night. And that's the night that I, as far as I can remember, that is the night that the show was recorded.
You
look really closely at one of the people in the club.
Stop you there, guys.
Have an Irish Independent in their hands. So there we go. Yeah.
Wow.
And I got away with it as well. And there was eyes everywhere. But I got away with it. I don't know how I got away with it, but I got away with it.
We all know now. No.
Thank you.
caught me peeping.